हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स। गुड मॉर्निंग।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
एम ऑडिबल?
यस सर।
ओके, एज सून एज यू एंटर लॉग इन, ओके, यू हैव टू एंटर योर यूएसएन एंड नेम इन द चैट बॉक्स सो दैट आई कैन गिव द अटेंडेंस। ओके, so you have to, all of you have to register in the chat box with your USN and name. Monica, am audible students, am audible? Okay, today I'll start new concept, that is refrigeration and air conditioning. That is a part of module 3. In the previous class we studied about internal combustion engine. Okay, so different types of internal combustion engine, like four stroke cycle engine, two stroke engine, petrol engine, diesel engine. Next we studied some parameters, okay, and also we studied the numerical problems. Okay, I have posted numerical problem in your Google sheet. Please go through the numerical problem, try to understand the numerical problems, because the most important problems I shared in your Google classroom. Okay, today I'll discuss the new part, that is called as refrigeration and air conditioning. Okay, before that, first you should know what is refrigeration. Nowadays refrigeration plays a very important role in day to day life, like to preserve foodstuffs, medical supplies and other important products. So we have to keep those product in cooled condition, okay, so that we have to keep them stay fresh and usable. That's why this refrigeration playing very important role in day to day life. First you should know what is the definition of refrigeration. Okay, refrigeration is a process of cooling or reducing the temperature of any substance below the atmospheric temperature. Not only reducing the temperature below the atmospheric temperature, we have to maintain that reduced temperature within the boundary of a given space. That is called as refrigeration. That is process of cooling or reducing the temperature of a substance below that of the surrounding atmosphere and maintaining that lower temperature within the boundary of given space. Okay, this is the definition. We have to maintain the temperature of a given substance below the atmospheric temperature, surrounding atmosphere. Already you know the atmospheric condition are usually 25 degrees Celsius and 1 bar atmospheric pressure. We have to reduce the temperature below that room temperature. That is called as refrigeration. Okay. Now we'll go through what are the application of refrigeration. As I said, the refrigeration plays very important role. First, in terms of food processing, preservation, and distribution. So to store raw fruits, vegetables, fish, meat, and poultry, refrigeration is used. On the other hand, we have to store dairy products like milk, butter, buttermilk, and ice cream. Production and pulling of beer, wine, and concentrated fruit juices. Processing and distribution of frozen food. Means we are going to use the refrigeration for storing of raw fruits, vegetables, fish, meat, and also our dairy products like milk, butter, buttermilk, and ice cream. Production and cooling of beer, wine, and concentrated fruit juices. Processing and distribution of frozen food. Okay, this is for food processing. Okay. Next application is chemical and process industry. Okay, so that we can use refrigeration for ice manufacturing, cold treatment of metals, and then manufacturing and preservation of medicines, chemicals in medical laboratories for storing test samples, etc. We are going to use the refrigeration. Desalination of water. Already you studied desalination of water in solar power plants. Means to reduce the salt content of water and to make it soft. That is called as desalination of water. Okay, first application is your food processing, preservation. Second application is your special application, like in the manufacture of ice, cold treatment of the metals. Means once you heat the metal for this one, it undergoes higher temperature. In order to keep the cool for this hot metals, we are using refrigeration. Then in the case of manufacturing and preservation of medicines, chemicals, etc., this refrigeration is used. In medical laboratories, for storing test samples, etc., this refrigeration is used. On the other hand, we are having another part called as air conditioning. Already you might have heard about air conditioning, that is summer air conditioning and winter air conditioning. In the summer air conditioning, we are going to decrease the temperature of the our room, etc. And in case of winter air conditioning, we are going to increase the temperature. So that this air conditioning is a part of refrigeration. Then I'll tell the difference between refrigeration and air conditioning. Refrigeration is a process of maintaining the temperature below the atmospheric temperature and maintaining that temperature within the boundary of given space. That is the definition of refrigeration. On the other hand, air conditioning is a part of refrigeration. In case of refrigeration, we can control only the temperature. So we are not going to control any other parameters. But in case of air conditioning, apart from temperature, we can control the humidity. Humidity means moisture content of the air. And also the air cleanliness is possible in case of air conditioning. Air cleanliness is not possible in case of refrigeration. So it is a simultaneous control of temperature, humidity. So air conditioning is simultaneous control of temperature, humidity, cleanliness, and air motion in a confined space. Okay, but it is not possible in case of refrigeration. You remember, air conditioning is a part of refrigeration. We can control only temperature in case of refrigeration. But in case of air conditioning, apart from temperature, we can control the humidity. Humidity means moisture content of the air. Okay. So refrigeration and air conditioning are generally involved for comfort application. Next, that is the difference. In air conditioning, we can control okay, so these are the applications of refrigeration and air conditioning. Okay, and we are having a types of refrigeration system. Basically, there are two types of refrigeration system. One is VCR, that is vapor compression refrigeration system, and another one is vapor absorption refrigeration system. In the exam, they may ask either VCR and VAR. Okay, so vapor compression refrigeration system and vapor absorption refrigeration system. In this class, I am going to discuss with vapor compression refrigeration system. Okay, so this is the line diagram of VCR, vapor compression refrigeration cycle. So any refrigeration cycle having basically four parts. You remember, evaporator, this is the first part, second one is compressor, third one is condenser, and fourth one is your expansion valve. Okay, evaporator, as you might have heard, coil-like structure exists in the fridge. So the main function of the evaporator is to change the phase from liquid to a vapor. That is the function of evaporator. In the evaporator, the liquid refrigerant is converting into the vapor phase. Okay, before that, you should know a material called as refrigerant. Okay, refrigerant is a carrier substance which is used in the refrigeration system. Okay, we are having so many refrigerant, like a Freon group of refrigerant. Next, we are having modern refrigerants. Next, we are having ammonia as a refrigerant. There are so many refrigerants available, so that I'll discuss these refrigerant in the next class. Okay, refrigerant is a carrier substance which is used in the refrigeration system. Okay, evaporator is a part where the conversion of liquid phase is converted into the gaseous phase. And the location of evaporator, the evaporator always present inside the fridge or inside the refrigeration system. Second part is called as compressor. Already you know the function of the compressor. The main function of compressor is to increase the pressure and temperature of working fluid. Okay, so we are having compressor. It is a part which is located at the bottom of the refrigeration system. You remember, evaporator coil is present inside the cabinet, inside the fridge, whereas the compressor is located at the bottom of the refrigeration system. Third part is called as condenser. Okay, it is very similar to your evaporator coil. The main function of the condenser, already you know the condensation. Condensation means the conversion of vapor to liquid, whereas function of evaporator is to convert liquid to vapor. Here it is opposite. The main function of the condenser is to convert vapor into liquid. And the location, the condenser is usually located at the back of the fridge or refrigeration system. apart from these three devices, we are having one more device called as expansion wall. Okay, so expansion wall, it is a wall, it is connecting between evaporator coil and condenser coil. Okay, so that whenever they ask, explain the vapor compression refrigeration cycle, means you have to draw this diagram. This is the most important diagram in the refrigeration system. We are having two types, as I said. One is vapor compression refrigeration system, or briefly it is written as VCR, vapor compression. Another one is vapor absorption refrigeration system. Okay, so before that, these are the four parts. Evaporator coil, it is located inside the cabinet, whereas compressor, it is located at the bottom of the compressor. Condenser, it is located at the back of the refrigeration system, whereas expansion wall is a link between evaporator coil and condenser coil. So these are the four important parts of your VCR, vapor compression refrigeration system. Okay, now I'll explain the working of VCR. You have to understand the working of VCR, most important. Okay, how it works. Okay, as I said, the refrigerant is used in the refrigeration system. It is a carrier substance which undergoes the change in phase from vapor to liquid in evaporator, and from vapor to liquid in case of condenser, and from liquid to vapor in case of evaporator. Refrigerant is a carrier substance that flows in the system, okay, and it undergoes the change of phases in different devices. Okay, so now I am going to start the cycle. Let us assume that the refrigerant, it is at low pressure and low temperature. Okay, we are going to start with the low temperature and low pressure liquid refrigerant enters inside the cabinet. Okay, inside, enters inside the evaporator, where the heat is absorbed. Okay, because this evaporator coil is kept inside the cabinet, so that whatever it enters, so it, the evaporator, as the refrigerant flows inside the evaporator coil, so the heat is get absorbed. So there is a change in phase from liquid to vapor. Whatever amount of the heat is there inside the cabinet, that is absorbed by the liquid refrigerant inside the evaporator coil. Okay, remember, evaporator coil, it is placed inside the cabinet. So the liquid refrigerant, which is at low pressure and low temperature, enters inside the evaporator coil. As it enters inside the evaporator coil, that liquid refrigerant absorbs the heat from the cabinet. As it absorbs the heat from the cabinet, the liquid refrigerant gets converted into the vapor refrigerant. You remember, so that whatever the heat present inside the cabinet, so that liquid refrigerant absorbs the heat from this cabinet. And as it absorbs the heat from the cabinet, the liquid is converted into the vapor. As I said, evaporator is a device where conversion of liquid into vapor phase takes place. So that you remember, first process is the low pressure and low temperature liquid refrigerant enters inside the evaporator coil, so that it absorbs the heat from surrounding space or from the cabinet. As it absorbs the heat from the cabinet, then the conversion of the phase takes place, that is from liquid to vapor. Then that vapor, low pressure and low temperature vapor, then enters into the compressor. As I said, compressor is a device which is placed at the bottom of the refrigeration system when the low pressure and a low temperature vapor refrigerant enters into the compressor, the pressure and temperature increases. Okay, we require the high pressure and high temperature vapor refrigerant for the circuit. Okay, so the main function of the compressor is to increase the pressure and temperature of the vapor refrigerant. Okay, what condition of refrigerant is here? The low pressure and low temperature vapor. Here the low temperature, low pressure liquid. Here low temperature and low pressure vapor, that is enters into the compressor. The compressor is a device which increases the pressure and temperature of the working fluid. When low pressure and low temperature vapor enters into the compressor, the pressure and temperature of the vapor gets increased. Okay, so what is the condition of refrigerant here? The high pressure and high temperature vapor. This is the condition of refrigerant after passing through the compressor. Okay, next, this high pressure, high temperature vapor refrigerant then enters into the condenser. Okay, condenser, as I said, it is very similar to your evaporator coil. It is placed behind the fridge and it consisting of certain set of coils. Okay, the main function of the condenser is to convert the vapor phase into the liquid phase. Okay, the condition of refrigerant is high pressure and high temperature vapor after passing through the compressor that enters into the condenser. Okay, condenser means when high pressure, high temperature vapor refrigerant enters into the condenser, it gives away the heat to the surroundings, whether it may be water or it may be air. Okay, so usually the condenser is placed behind the fridge so that the whatever the heat is there inside the refrigerant, it gives away that heat to the surrounding atmosphere. Okay, as it gives away the heat to the surrounding atmosphere, the temperature decreases. Now, what is the condition of refrigerant here? After passing through the condenser, the vapor refrigerant converted into the liquid refrigerant and the high temperature is converted into low temperature. Okay, the condition is most important in case of evaporator, so that there will be change in phase from liquid to vapor, in case of condenser from vapor to liquid. So when high pressure, high temperature vapor refrigerant enters into the condenser, next the conversion takes place, that is from vapor to liquid. As it converts vapor into liquid, the temperature drops. So we'll get high pressure and low temperature liquid refrigerant. Okay, next part is your expansion valve. The condition of refrigerant is in high pressure. It is not suitable to take that high pressure refrigerant for next cycle of operation. For safe working of refrigerator system, we have to reduce the pressure to lower pressure limit. For efficient working of refrigerator, we have to reduce that pressure to lower limits. Okay, so the condition of refrigerant is here high pressure, low temperature liquid refrigerant. Okay, then the as I said, the expansion valve, it is like a throttle valve or orifice valve. It makes connection between evaporator coil and condenser coil. It performs two functions. Means first function is it reduces the pressure of liquid refrigerant to low pressure refrigerant for the next cycle of operation. And another function of expansion valve is to regulate the flow of refrigerant inside the refrigeration system. So these are the two functions of expansion valve or throttle valve. First one is it reduces the pressure of refrigerant to the low pressure within the practical limits for next cycle of operation. Second function is it controls or regulates the flow of refrigerant inside the refrigeration system. Okay, so that when it passes through the expansion valve, the high pressure liquid refrigerant is converted into the low pressure liquid refrigerant. Anyhow, there is no change in temperature, means low temperature refrigerant only the continues in the next cycle of operation. So we'll get low temperature, low pressure, the liquid refrigerant enters into the evaporator for next cycle of operation. Okay, just you remember, these are the four basic parts of your refrigeration system. Okay, first one is evaporator, second one is condenser, third one is compressor, and fourth one is expansion valve. Okay, so I'll explain the function once again. Okay, evaporator is a coil like structure which is placed inside the cabinet, which is placed inside the cabinet of the refrigeration system. Compressor is a component which is placed at the bottom of the refrigeration system. Condenser is once again a coil-like structure which is placed at the back of the refrigeration system, whereas expansion valve is a valve which is connected between the evaporator and condenser. Okay, these are the parts and the location. And you remember the function, evaporator is a coil like structure where the conversion of liquid to vapor takes place. Okay, and second one is compressor. The main function of the compressor is to increase the pressure and temperature of the working fluid. What is the working fluid here? Is refrigerant. Okay, refrigerant is a carrier substance which is used in the refrigeration system, which undergoes sequence of the operation from liquid to vapor in evaporator and from vapor to liquid in the condenser. Okay, the main function of the compressor is to compress the vapor refrigerant to high pressure and high temperatures, and also it performs another function like is absorbing function over and again. Okay, this is another function of compressor. The condenser, the main function of the condenser is to convert the vapor refrigerant into the liquid refrigerant. Okay, next, expansion valve. As I said, it is a link between a evaporator coil and condenser coil. The main function of the expansion valve is to regulate, means we have to supply proper refrigerant for the next cycle of the operation. That function is performed by expansion valve, that is to regulate the flow of refrigerant for the next cycle of operation, and also to reduce the high pressure liquid refrigerant into the low pressure liquid refrigerant for the next cycle of operation. Okay, so I'll repeat once again the working principle. Always you have to start with low pressure and low temperature liquid refrigerant. Refrigerant may be ammonia or freon or sulfur dioxide, etc. Okay, this is all about the vapor compression refrigeration system. Hello. Hello. Okay, after this one, I'll discuss some important terms used in the refrigeration system. Okay, next I'll discuss what are the terms used in the refrigeration system. Okay, I hope you understood VCR. So these are the simple terms used in the refrigeration system. First one is refrigeration. Refrigeration is defined as the process of reducing the temperature of a given space below that of surrounding atmosphere, as I said in the beginning of the session. The Refrigeration is defined as the process of maintaining the temperature below the surrounding atmosphere, and you have to maintain that temperature throughout the system. That is called as refrigeration. Okay. Second definition is your refrigerating effect. Okay. Second definition is called as refrigerating effect. It is defined as how much amount of the cooling is produced by the refrigeration process in one cycle. Already studied a VCR. Okay. So how much amount of the cooling takes place in a cycle is called as refrigerating effect. It is also defined as how much amount of the heat is removed from the system in one cycle of operation. That is called as refrigeration effect. Okay. The rate at which the heat is removed from the system in one cycle of operation is called as the refrigerating effect. Don't make confusion between refrigerating effect and refrigeration. And ton of refrigeration. How we are going to express the various units for various parameters like that. The capacity of refrigerators can be expressed in terms of ton of refrigeration. For example, work we are going to express in terms of joule, then power we are going to express in terms of joules per second. In the same way, the refrigeration capacity is going to express in terms of a unit called as ton of refrigeration. It is abbreviated as TOR. TOR means ton of refrigeration. Okay, it is defined as the amount of heat absorbed to produce 1 ton. Don't make confusion. 1 ton means is not 1000 kg. It is a unit used in the refrigeration system. It is how much amount of the heat absorbed to produce 1 ton of ice in 24 hours. That is in one day from water. Okay. Whose initial temperature is 0 degrees Celsius. Okay. So in order to convert water into ice, we have to remove the heat from that water. So it is the rate at which the heat is absorbed in order to produce 1 ton of ice from the water at 0 degrees Celsius. That is called as ton of refrigeration. You remember the ton of refrigeration is equals to 3.5 kilowatts, you remember. So there is one derivation. Derivation is not required. Just you remember, 1 ton of refrigeration, nothing but 210 kilojoules per minute, or 210 divided by 60. How much you'll get? 3.5 kilojoules per second. That is 3.5 kilowatts. This is the third definition. And fourth definition is your ice making capacity. Very simple term. It is defined as capacity of refrigeration system to remove the heat. How much amount of the heat is removed from the water to make ice? That is called as ice making capacity. It is defined as capacity of a refrigeration system to remove the heat from the water to make ice. Okay. And the last term is your refrigeration cycle. As I said, it has to undergo the sequence of operation, evaporation, condensation, compression, and throttle valve. That is called as cycle. Means that changes takes place in the refrigerant as it alternatively absorbs. Where it absorbs the heat? It absorbs the heat in evaporator and rejects the heat in case of condenser. Okay. It undergoes alternate change of phase. And one more is there. That is coefficient of performance. So don't make confusion between TOR and COP. TOR is unit and COP is, it is going to express in terms of COP. It is similar to your efficiency of IC engine. We are going to express efficiency in IC engine and we are going to express COP in case of refrigeration. It is defined as how much amount of the heat is removed to the work supplied. That is represented by Q by W. In order to make the water to ice, we have to remove the heat. That is how much amount of the heat is removed in a system to the work supplied. Just it is a ratio of Q by W. Okay. So